Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another Shopify how-to video, and in this video I'll walk you through how you can add size chart to your Shopify product page using collapsible row section. So you'll be able to add image of your product size chart within your product page using collapsible row section, and this size chart will be updated through Metafield. So for example, if you have like 20 products and each of the product have a separate size detailing and the size chart, then you can use the meta field and upload the size chart to every single product using the collapsible row section. So if you want to learn how to do this, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, comment the video below, which will help me to create more nice quality and valuable content for you guys. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen. So guys, that's how the product page will look like, and we have size chart showing up on our product page in a collapsible row section, and this size chart is pulling up through Metafield. So that's the back end of my product, and if I scroll down, you can see that I have this size chart pulling up through a Metafield. So you won't be creating new template for every single product if you have separate size charts, if you have multiple products. So let's get into it and try implement that. First, what I'm gonna do, I'll install a new theme because there are some theme changes which I'll have to do in order to add image in collapsible row section. So that's the theme where I've already added the code. I'm going to add a fresh DOM theme. So just click on add DOM and it will install a fresh DOM theme. Okay guys, so our DOM theme has been installed. Now hit publish. And let's customize it and add collapsible row section in this theme. Click on customize. And from there, we have this top menu showing up where we can select product template. So click on this top arrow and then click on products, then select default product. So that's how our product template looks like. Now let's add a collapsible row. Click on this add block here and select collapsible row. Now here we have our collapsible row showing up. Now when you click on that, you can simply change the heading to size chart. And let's change the icon as well to ruler, which looks like the size. Yep, here it is. Okay. And now if you notice, we have this raw content where we can add text, but we cannot add image. Now, in order to solve this issue, we'll need to edit code in our theme file. Now let's hit save. And let's go to our code editor. So here we will click on online store. And then from online store, click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. So in case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Now let's click on edit code. And in here, we will search for main-product.liquid file. So in main-product.liquid file, scroll down to line number 1089. Okay, so that's the line where we'll have to do some changes. So in here, you are seeing it rich text. We will just replace it to liquid so we can add a liquid code instead of raw content. So line number might be a little different for you if you are on a different theme. I'm currently on DAWN 11.0.0. And you can alternatively search for this code. And above this code, you will see type which you need to replace from rich text to liquid. I'm going to add a detailed blog post in this YouTube video description, which will help you add the code and with more details on where you need to replace the code. Okay, so for now, I'm going to replace rich text with liquid and hit save. And after saving the file, when I go to customize and hit refresh in my product template file, now you can see that it's showing raw content, where we can simply add image SRC and add any image using our HTML code. That's cool, right? So now we are able to add images to in our size chart. Now the next step is to create meta field and put the meta field value in shape of image within this size chart. Okay, now let's create a meta field. Let's go to settings, click on this settings from your main dashboard, and from there click on custom data. So here's custom data, click on that. And now let's create a new meta field, click on products and click on add definition. And here we will create a new meta field called size chart. And the type of this meta field should be image. So click on select type and click on file. Once done, scroll down and uncheck video. If you want to, you can also include video if you want, but for now I just need images, so I'll just uncheck the video and then click save. Now once we have our meta field ready, what we're gonna do, we will simply copy this code to customize settings. So copy this code and go to your customize and simply paste this code to your collapsible row section. Don't worry about the code. Again, I'll add the blog post in YouTube video description, so you can simply copy and paste the code. Okay, now what we need to do is just upload our image to the meta field. One thing you will need to make sure that this is where we are calling our meta field. So this should be matching to what you have created. So currently it's product.metafields.custom.size_chart. So whatever meta field you create, you should match your code with this. And once you do that, you can simply copy this code and paste it to your customized settings. Okay, now let's add the meta field to our product. So currently I am on female t-shirt product. Let's add in a size chart to this product. So go to products. And now I'm going to search for the product. Here it is. Now I go to this product. And now let's upload my size chart to the meta field, which shows up at the bottom. So that's the meta field which I have created. Click on this. And here is it's asking to upload the size chart. Now click on select image. And I already have uploaded a size chart. So I'm just going to select it and click done. Okay, now hit save. And let's preview our product. Okay, so that's our product. And if I scroll down and open up my collapsible row, you can see that my size chart is showing up and it will show only to this product. If I go to any other product, it will not show any image. So let's check that out. Let's try uploading a different image to any different clothing product. So we have this gray t-shirt, and if I go to the size chart for this product, it's not showing anything. Now we have option on the back end to upload a different size chart for this product. So I can simply go to this product and upload my size chart to the meta field of this product here, and it will simply show up on this collapsible row section. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you will be benefited from this tutorial which I created. If you want me to create more tutorials for you guys like this, feel free to comment below and let me know what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.